I think that Ellison helps us to understand some of the dynamics that exist for individuals who are marginalized in society. He does a very great job of articulating what some of those experiences could be like.
When you look around our world today, we're very much divided. And I think Ellison brings about a unification, this idea that at the core, understanding who you are helps you understand not only people around you, but the world around you. The mission of the Ralph Ellison Foundation is to highlight the accomplishments of Mr. Ellison and also to do programming in three specific areas: music, art, and literature.
Whether you're brand new to Oklahoma, brand new to Oklahoma City, or you've lived here your entire life, this story defines us. And for many of us, there are huge gaps in that story. Ellison is an important part of that legacy for all Oklahomans. And understanding Ellison's role in Oklahoma helps us understand ourselves.
I've seen the growth of the foundation. I feel that the community, especially in the metro area now, are really understanding what we're about, embracing what our work is, and willing to participate and want to partner with our foundation to bring it to a higher level.
And so, you know, we just have been very intentional with creating programming and different ways in which Oklahoma and now nationally he be recognized.
The Lightbulb Room is a series of conversations based on the challenges that we face with race, discrimination, invisibility, identity, and so forth. It's received national attention. It's a space within which people can come to talk about difficult topics.
I felt it was cathartic to be able to have a conversation about something that I feel very passionate about, some frustrations that I experience as an artist of color or a person of color in primarily white spaces. So it was a great experience for me, and I would definitely do it again.
So yeah, with the Lightbulb Room, by introducing an Ellison text, then having a panel of people assembled who can really speak relevantly to that topic, it sets the stage for a great kind of conversation where everyone in the room should be kind of considered equal. Well, we're really proud for these last, going on 4 years now, to do a creative writing workshop series at the library that bears Ralph Ellison's name in Northeast Oklahoma City. And it's a free workshop. We've got a different guest instructor every month, and it draws different people who might be interested in poetry, in fiction, in playwriting, in autobiography, even hip-hop lyrics.
The fact that you don't have to take an MFA program or spend money on any kind of class or workshop or go to some writer's retreat in the mountains, you can just go to your neighborhood library and get some of the same kinds of voices that you would get if you did go to those kind of programs. I think that that's a game changer. Elevating the regular person to this creative level where they can do things that they might not have had access to. I think that that honors his legacy. It makes people feel visible.
The Mural Project was created to address middle school students. And the curriculum is based upon giving them the opportunity to talk about their past, their present, and their future. And then they mural that. It's an art class. And so they draw that. They express what they've been through, where they're at right now, and their aspirations for the future.
So they make an individual mural, and then the actual mural display, they're all put into the display as one large collective.
You know, you have each individual person being able to express themselves and then having it come collective as one large mural, then they have this shared experience that is then shared with everyone.
Things that we cannot express verbally, we can express them in the abstract, right? We can express them in ways that words cannot describe. And so I am so excited that this program is at Classen SAS, and it's just flourishing. A Flying Home was created. It's a curriculum that was created for high school students. And it's based upon Ellison's Flying Home series.
And so we would love to work with multiple school districts throughout the state, assisting teachers in being able to implement Flying Home into their classroom literary as well as in art classrooms and music classrooms.
And again, this is bringing Ellison into spaces that he was never before. That's why he's so relevant today. That's why he's such a great writer. That's why we turn to Ellison, because we find in his works answers to the many challenges that we face today. I'm excited about our latest program, Ralph Ellison, a Solo Act, that brings in local artists, solo artists, as well as dramatic dance, music, and reading. And a small vignette where people can experience these artists up close and personal.
So performing at the Solo Act was an immersive experience between myself as a dancer, there was also a spoken word artist, and there was also a violinist. And we all have three different voices in the three different things that we do, and all three of those voices were heard.
If you can get into one of these solo acts, I want to encourage you too, because I think you'll leave profoundly changed.
We're seeing this organization do such important work with very limited resources relative to organizations of this type in Oklahoma and around the nation. And we see the organization facilitating and encouraging discussions and thoughtful dialogues in not just in metropolitan areas, but around the state.
The foundation is at a point of growth. And we were so fortunate to receive an operational grant of $25,000 from the Kirkpatrick Family Fund to build capacity. And so what does the foundation need now? Well, we need to bring it to its fruition. We need to ensure that it has a staff that can support the day-to-day operations.
You know, we have a mission, we have a vision of where we'd like the foundation to be, but we can't do it alone. And so our community partners and stakeholders are valuable, or just, we've got to have them in order to take it to the next level.
The foundation has a desire to make the world better, to make our community better, to make those we service better, to empower people, and to really make an imprint. It taps into the idea of what does it mean to be human? And when we can answer that question, and we can utilize what Ellison says to answer that question, in the end, we will see, I will see you in me, and you will see me in you.